This Colorado tornado slithered across the Sedgwick County farm Wednesday evening, captured at close range.
The funnel was pretty much directly above me, but it came down at an angle, so where it came down on the ground was probably about 200 or 300 yards away from me.
Brett Kirk had to hop off his combine and grab his cell phone as Mother Nature added a special twist to this year's wheat harvest. Fortunately, it missed the grain bins and the farm equipment, only knocking down an empty storage shed.
It was kind of mesmerizing. It was really neat looking.
And Brett wasn't the only one to see it up close. This is a type of tornado known as a landspout. It just forms a little differently than your classic supercell tornado. With a landspout tornado, there's already invisible air rotating horizontally near the ground. As a thunderstorm moves over it or rapidly forms nearby, the rotating air gets pulled into the thunderstorm, forming a tornado, like a dust devil that gets attached to a thunderstorm base. They usually hang down from the flat bottom of the storm with no wall cloud present. The cloud base in yesterday's storm was likely more than 3,000 feet high, which means anyone in Julesburg, Amherst, Holyoke, and Venango could see it. But that doesn't mean it was the only tornado. Here's a likely separate twister that was seen touching down closer to Grant, Nebraska, more than 20 miles away. And more tornadoes were reported from Ogallala to Lake Mack. It is also common with landspouts to have multiple tornadoes on the ground at the same time. When storms form near a boundary of rotating air at the surface, there are often multiple updrafts that lift up landspout tornadoes. Meteorologist Corey Reppenhagen, 9 News.